Every time our eyes meet, this feeling inside me is almost more than I can take. Baby, when you touch me, I can feel how much you love me, and it just blows me away. I've never been this close to anyone or anything. I can hear your thoughts, I can see your dreams. I don't know how you do what you do. I'm so in love with you. It just keeps getting better. I want to spend the rest of my life with you by in my heart. Oh, it feels like the first time, every time. I want to spend the whole night in your eyes. I don't know how you do what you do. I'm so in love with you. It just keeps getting better. Baby, when you touch me, I can feel how much you love me, and it just blows me away. I've never been this close to anyone or anything. I can hear your thoughts, I can see your dreams. I don't know how you do what you do. So in love with you, it just keeps getting better. I wanna spend the rest of my life with you by my side. dark. Your hair all around me, baby, you surround me. You touch every place in my heart. Oh, it feels like the first time, every time.
With you by my side, forever and ever. Every little thing that you do, baby, I'm amazed by you. Time our eyes meet, this feeling inside me is almost more than I can take. Baby, when you touch me, I can feel how much you love me, and it just blows me away. I've never been this close to anyone or anything. I can hear thoughts.
Who gives his bride to this man?
Your mother and I do.
I don't know how you do what you do. I'm so in love with you. It just keeps getting better. Can you remove my veil? All right. We are gathered here today in the sight of God and in the presence of friends and loved ones to celebrate one of life's greatest moments. We are here to give recognition to the beauty of love that is shared between Christopher and Danielle as they complete their family in holy matrimony. Marriage is a contract not to be entered into lightly, but thoughtfully and seriously, and with a deep realization of the obligations and responsibilities. Marriage is the moment when your hearts and souls are joined together for eternity. Let's bow in prayer. Heavenly Father, we humbly bow before you today, praising you, Lord, and your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, we ask you for your blessings upon Christopher and Danielle as we celebrate this momentous occasion in their lives. Grant them happiness and contentment as their two lives become one, as they create a new family and explore the depths of their love for one another. Bless their families and friends and the relationships which have supported, strengthened, sustained them throughout their lives. Bless their home as a place of love and of peace. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. The joining of two hearts as husband and wife is a commitment like none other. It offers opportunities for sharing and for personal growth that no other human relationship can equal. A husband and wife are each other's best friends, confidants, lovers, teachers, listeners, and critics. The bond between a husband and wife deeply enriches every fact of life. Happiness is fuller and commitments are stronger. Marriage also encourages new life and new experiences and finds new ways of expressing love through the ups and downs of life. Christopher and Danielle, as your journey begins as husband and wife, I would ask you both to remember to always treat each other with respect and remind yourself often what brought you here today. I'd like to just insert here a few words from our Heavenly Father about love. There are three types of love that are all important in marriage. First of all, there's eros, which is that physical wow attraction, which probably brought you together in the first place. And that's important. The next one is phileo. It is that friendship kind of love that you're each other's best friends, and you need to be the top best friends forever. But the most important, and the one ordained by God and given to us by God, is agape love. It's unconditional, and it's never ending. So we're going to take a trip to 1 Corinthians 13. I may speak in different languages of people or angels, but if I do not have love, I'm only a noisy bell or a clanging cymbal. I may have the gift of prophecy. I may understand all the secret things of God and have all knowledge. And I may have faith so great I can move mountains. But even with all these things, if I do not have love, I am nothing. I may give away everything I have, and I may even give my body as an offering to be burned, but I gain nothing if I do not have love. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous. It does not brag, and it is not proud. Love is not rude. It is not selfish, and does not get upset with others. Love does not count up wrongs that have been done. Love is not happy with evil, but is happy with the truth. Love patiently accepts all things. It always trusts, always hopes, and always remains strong. Love never ends. There are gifts of prophecy, but they will end. There are gifts of speaking in different languages, but those gifts will stop. There's a gift of knowledge, but it will come to an end. The reason that our knowledge and our ability to prophesy is not perfect. But when perfection comes, the things that are not perfect will end. When I was a child, I talked like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. But when I became a man, I stopped childish ways. It is the same with us. Now we see a dim reflection, as if we were looking into an old mirror. But then we will see clearly, because we will see God face to face. Now I know in part, but then I will know fully, as God has fully known me. So these three things continue forever: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. So therefore, Christopher and Danielle, and everyone here who will listen, let this active love be part of our daily lives. Okay, I see you're already facing each other and holding hands. So, Danielle, would you please repeat after me?
Okay.
Christopher. Danielle, do you take Christopher to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, to love, honor, and cherish in sickness and health, forsaking others for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Christopher, do you take Danielle to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, to love, honor, and cherish in sickness and in health, forsaking all others for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Who has the rings? The ring is an unbroken circle representing unending love. Christopher and Danielle will pledge to love each other as often as either of you look upon these rings. May you be reminded of this moment and the love you have promised to one another. Christopher, did you take this ring? Not that ring. That ring. Christopher, place this ring on Danielle's finger, and this time repeat after me. Danielle.
Danielle.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And that I'm choosing.
Then that I'm choosing.
To share my life's journey with you.
To share my life's journey with you.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
With the pledge to love you today.
With the pledge to love you today.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And always.
And always.
All right, Danielle. Place the ring on Chris's finger and repeat after me. Christopher.
Christopher.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And that I'm choosing to share my life's journey with you.
And that I'm choosing to share my life's journey with you.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
With the pledge to love you today.
With the pledge to love you today.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
And always.
And always.
Danielle and Christopher, I want to wish you both much happiness and love as you begin this new journey. They would like to do something very special with a rope.
Wherever that is.
My reach here. AJ, come on over here a second. Today, Christopher and Danielle have chosen to braid 3 strands together into a single cord. Each strand has a significant meaning. One strand represents their God, declaring his place in their marriage. One strand represents Christopher in his life, and the other strand represents Danielle in her life. In the braiding of these 3 strands together, Christopher and Danielle are demonstrating that their marriage is more than a joining of 2 lives together. It is a unity with God as well. They are choosing to allow God to be at the center of their marriage, woven into every aspect of it. So, bring it to all the people in the line and then in the rows.
Let everybody touch it, AJ.
Everybody's got to put their hand on this rope.
Cameron's snatching it.
Okay,
let me get her, AJ. I want to do one.
Okay, we'll let you do one in a minute. Just pass it on down the line. And as everyone is touching the rope, Ecclesiastes 4:12 reads, "The one may be overpowered, 2 can defend themselves, but a cord of 3 strands is not easily broken." Today, Danielle and Christopher have been woven together by God as one in marriage, one man, one woman, and God. It was God who taught us to love. By keeping him at the center of your marriage, his love will continue to bind you together as one throughout your marriage.
Go ahead.
AJ, this way.
No, that's it. Has to touch it.
Did you guys touch it? Yeah, they did.
Oh, they did? Oh. Mm-hmm. All right, this is the hard part. I tried to teach Christopher, but we'll see. All right, go that way. Go that way. That's way too, I guess. Oh, gosh. This is... No, no, you got to go over.
Okay.
Cameron, you can hold it. You can hold it.
Yep. We're doing it.
Sometimes the beginning of the journey is a little rough. Where they're tying this rope. But it's going to come out beautiful.
I might have to rebraid it, but it's okay. Actually, it doesn't look bad. No, no, no. Come on.
I'm so sorry.
You've been doing so good. I don't know how we're going to tie it at the end.
All right, well, we'll do that later.
I don't know how to tie it.
Okay, that's good.
I'll just loop it. Hold on.
There we go. Okay.
Sorry, y'all.
This is what marriage is all about. Improvise, you know.
We'll just loop it enough to make it stay, and then I can figure out how to tie it later.
Okay. Not too bad.
Can I hold it?
You can touch it. You touch it.
No, let me do it.
Okay, we can't do it again, because this is the...
No, I can do it again.
You can hold it, okay?
You can hold it. Just hold on to it.
All right.
But I'm allowed to pass it.
Okay, we'll do that later.
No, do that today.
All right. This is the important part.
Then I'm gonna do it.
All right, just stand right there, buddy.
All right, Christopher and Danielle, you have pledged your faith to each other in the company of friends and family by the power vested in me by the state of Virginia. I now pronounce you husband and wife. Christopher, you may... Oh, go ahead, yeah. You may kiss your beautiful bride. Okay, turn face everyone. Family and friends, I am proud to present for the first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Christopher Weber Nieves.
Time.